Our breaking news tonight, President Trump on defense over the decision to name a special counsel in the Russia investigation. Let's discuss now. Senior political commentators Anna Navarro's here, Kevin Madden, Alice Stewart, and Matt Lewis. Good evening to all of you. Alice, you first. The president calling the entire thing a witch hunt. He also tweeted today that he is the most unfairly treated president in history. Are Republicans proud of President Trump's chief executive as victim posture?
It depends on who you ask. I mean, we all can acknowledge that a lot of the situations he's facing are self-inflicted wounds. And right now, with the current situation, the silence among many Republicans is deafening. And when we do hear from some, we have some coming out saying this is like Watergate. Some are saying the White House is in downward spiral. But more than anything, what we're seeing is many Republicans are now saying, let's wait. Now that it's in the special counsel has been appointed, let them do their job. Let them follow the facts where they lead and let them do their job. Meanwhile, the Republicans here in Washington are focusing on getting their agenda through, getting it passed, and as we saw from Speaker Ryan yesterday, focusing on pro-growth tax reform, making sure that they do away with burdensome regulations. Over on the Senate side, they're working on their version of health care. So in a way, it's a blessing we have this council. They can do their job and let members of Congress do their job
and get
their agenda through.
Kevin, is any of that getting through because the president is off, you know, saying things and doing things and tweeting and press conferences about other things when he could use the occasion of having a special counsel appointed and say, listen, I cannot talk about that. We're going to move on with our agenda.
Well, Alice is right in that the Republican Party's salvation does lie in promoting their agenda, fulfilling the promises that they made to the American public in 2016. But yes, it is certainly a huge distraction. I mean, if you're up on Capitol Hill right now, you're not getting as many questions about tax reform or health care as you are where you stand on the, you know, bombshell of the day. And it's been like that. This week in Washington has felt like 5 months when it comes to the revelations every single day that come out against the White House. For members of Congress having to relitigate that every single day and then possibly go home and relitigate it as well, it does provide a huge distraction for them.
Anna Navarro, throughout all of these controversies, and there have been a number of them, people have asked the question, I'm sure you've been asked as well, and maybe you've asked the question yourself, at what point do Republicans really start distancing themselves from the president? What do you think?
You know, I think today was an important point. When Lindsey Graham came out of the briefing with Deputy Attorney General Rosenstein and said that this had possibly gone from a counterintelligence investigation to a criminal investigation, that's going to have had an effect on a lot of Republicans. The word criminal means a lot. I can tell you it made my jaw drop and it made me look at this in a very different light. And I think Republicans are going to have to do what Paul Ryan has been saying all along, which is walk and chew gum at the same time. We sit there day after day listening to the speaker's press conference, hearing him try to speak and talk to us about tax reform and health care. And I think most of us are sitting there going, okay, Paul, that's really nice, but can you please get on to the really meaty stuff? Look, a lot of America right now is going around with paper bags that they're breathing into in the side of their cars. These are not daily revelations, like Kevin just said. These are hourly revelations. People are afraid to be, you know, away from the Wi-Fi or away from the internet, away from the TV, because you don't know what other shoe will drop when. The country's living in a state of anxiety. Republicans and Democrats are having to go home and face constituents who are screaming at them about this issue at town halls and at, you know, constituent meetings. So this is not something that they can sweep away. And at the same time, you've got a White House with 36-37% approval who are in crisis management mode hourly, and you're hearing hourly that different people might be about to get fired. It is a lot of drama going on.
Hey, I've got to ask you, Matt Lewis, I mean, what do you think of that? Because I'm speaking to people today and they say, my gosh, every single alert I get, I have palpitations, like the SNL skit, where they said, can I just get, you know, one alert from CNN a day that doesn't give me a heart attack?
Yeah, you know, you take a nap at 5 o'clock in the afternoon or something and you could miss a huge news story. And like, I think this takes a toll on journalists who have to cover this constantly. There's not a lot of sympathy for journalists, I'm sure, but, you know.
Well, I mean, just the average. This wasn't a journalist I was speaking to. This is just an average, you know, a person who pays attention to the news.
Yeah, yeah, it's overwhelming. It never stops. I think that Donald Trump likes drama. Some of this is Donald Trump being Trump. You know, he's created a really big reality show, and he likes to feed drama. But I think that there is getting to be some Trump fatigue, and I think that some of, if you're going to start to see Republicans walking away from this guy, some of it is just the accretion of every day there's another scandal.
Yeah.
Another shoe to drop.
2015.
There's five scandals a day, not one.
2015, Anna, my friend who I spoke of said was Netflix and chill. 2017 is news alert and freak out.
Oh, yeah. Listen, Don, I had the misfortune of trying to start a cleanse this week. Let me tell you, there is no way people can give up carbs, refined sugar, and alcohol right now. You can't give up anything. You need as many coping mechanisms as you can
okay.
have.
All right. We'll move on. We'll continue our conversation on the other side of the break. Don't go anywhere. Back now with my panel, and I'm going to turn to Kevin Madden now. Kevin, you were talking about coping mechanisms, but this is serious stuff that people are having to deal with. Republican members of Congress continue to confront crowds of angry constituents at town halls all across the country. Is this early signs of the political price that some may pay for supporting President Trump and some of his policies?
Well, look, I think it is less to do with the president's policies and has much more to do with this Democrat. This enthusiasm among the Democratic base, where they've defined right now their party's profile with resistance to Trump, and it's not necessarily the specifics of legislation, but just the fact that they believe that Donald Trump is just taking the country in the wrong direction. So energy that is on the Democratic side has to be taken very seriously by a lot of Republicans. Because if you also couple it with the fact that Donald Trump has had a hard time with independents during his early parts of his administration, that is what sets up some of the conditions for a very difficult year in 2018.
Yeah. Hey, Alice, let's look at the president's approval rating. President Trump's approval rating now at 38%. CNN's Chris Salizza writes that his poll numbers should terrify Republicans because, as he points out, since 1946, when presidents are above 50% approval, the party loses an average of 14 seats in the U.S. House in the midterm elections, compared with an average loss of 36 seats when presidents are below that mark. What do you think?
I think it's going to be important for the GOP to keep focus on their legislative agenda. Look, I'll acknowledge over the last several weeks when Hillary lost this campaign, Democrats have been waking up in the fetal position. You can tell it. It's been palpable in the air here in D.C., and there's been a spring in their step over the last few days with all that's unraveled with regard to Russia. And it's important for the administration and for conservatives to stop the talk on Russia and get back focused on the agenda. And when they go back in their districts, talk about what they're doing to fulfill the promises they made to their constituents.
Okay, that's Alice, let me ask you this. Let me just jump in here, and I don't mean to cut you off. But shouldn't you and other conservatives and constituents and people in Washington, shouldn't you and the people around him, shouldn't they be saying that to the president of the United States? He has the megaphone. He sets the news agenda. He sets the message. It's really not those people and who are going home to their constituents. They're just going to hear from the constituents.
I certainly hope there's people in the White House that are telling him that in regards to stop tweeting about Russia, tweet about your agenda, tweet about what you plan to accomplish on your foreign trip. This is an important trip for us to establish our leadership in the world and build relationships with leaders and reaffirm our unity with our allies abroad. Yeah. Hey, that's what he needs to focus on and show how powerful
Anna and Matt in with less 30 seconds. I mean, he's 70 years old. Is he going to change, Anna?
Sweetheart, I've got a little bit of experience with men, let me tell you. You don't change them. You really don't change men after 15. No matter what you do, you don't change them. They've got formative years, and they're very short.
Matt.
So you can forget changing an adult man at this time. We were all surprised that he hadn't tweeted for about a day and a half or 2 days. Apparently, supervising adult hid his phone, but he found it this morning.
Matt,
I'll agree with Anna on changing the man thing.
No impulse control, no message discipline. So even if the special prosecutor tamps down on leaks on that end, Trump can't resist tweeting about Russia.
Okay, last word I'll say. Check Anna's Twitter feed. You know what I'm talking about. Chris Evans, Anna, nice job. Thanks,
God,
everyone.
We need a superhero.
Yeah, thank you all. I appreciate it. When we come back, why the president reportedly made FBI Director James Comey uneasy.